Hello everyone, my name's Anthony Hull and I'm part of the Traverse Project team. So what I thought I'd do today would be to give you a walk and talk through our Lego model of our planned Traverse. One of the main purposes of the Traverse capability is to deliver a mobile inland station to a site approximately 1200 kilometres inland from Casey Station. At the front we have kind of the where we feed and prepare meals, which has been designed to cater for 16 people. Obviously, being at such a remote site, 1200 kilometres from the coast of Antarctica, we need to look after our expeditioners from a medical perspective. So part of the inland station will be a containerised medical facility, and that will be staffed by a doctor. Overall, we've had to manage the weight of the Traverse, so some of the structures we will use at the mobile inland station will be tents. So there's a series of tents that are going to be used to support the million year ice core component, which is the reason why we're putting the mobile inland station on site. But also some of the tents will be used as a mechanical workshop because they're bigger structures we can erect on site, which give us more space but also save us weight for the overall Traverse we have to transport. The most exciting thing about the new Traverse capability and the mobile inland station is the endeavour to drill for a million year ice core, which is kind of the scientific holy grail in glaciology at the moment. So this will be the primary focus for the next 5 or 6 years of the Antarctic program. So what we need to transport inland is all the drilling equipment and infrastructure to enable us to drill for this million year ice core. So behind this tractor, we have the ice core drill and winch. So this drill is going to drill approximately 3 kilometres through the ice cap. So we need to put all of the supporting power generation, scientific instrumentation to support that drilling process. Once the ice cores are drilled, they'll be brought to the surface. They'll undergo some scientific processing and analysis. For us to be able to return the ice cores to Australia, we've had to put a system in so they don't thaw out on the way back to Australia. They'll be temperature controlled so we can make sure we don't lose those ice cores. The procedures at the end of the day, this snow groomer here, his job during the day has been to groom the Traverse route out the front to knock down the lumps and bumps so this Traverse train can travel smoothly. The first job when parking up for the night will be to move through this area and turn this into a car park for the other pieces of plant or the tractors and the groomers. The reason we need to do this is overnight we need to plug all of these vehicles, the tractors and the groomers, into power because this allows us the next day to wake up and move away from our overnight camp with warm machinery. The whole Traverse capability will have actually 5 of these tractor and Traverse trains behind them. On the table we've got 3 here for you. So the overall capability needs to be able to tow about 400 tonnes inland. So we need to distribute that load across 5 tractors because roughly we can put 80 tonnes behind a single tractor. When we're actually on the Traverse route, there's one road being prepared out the front by the groomers. So that's the function of these guys. They knock those lumps and bumps off the Traverse route. The temperature range that we can expect from sea level right up to 3200 metres, there could be a difference of minus 30 and minus 40 temperatures. So that's the reason when we've designed the Traverse and the living infrastructure, we've had to build them to withstand those temperatures. Noting that that happens during the summer period, we'll be active from December through to February on a given year. But we can't bring all of this equipment and gear back home during the winter because the Traverse will be too heavy for the following season when the Traverse has to go back up the hill. So the plan will be to leave some of the infrastructure at the mobile inland station site. From a temperature perspective there, some of these living vans may need to withstand temperatures as cold as minus 60 or minus 70. So there's been a lot of thought and planning put into not only the design of the living vans themselves, but also the tractors and the groomers have been heavily modified to suit those Antarctic conditions. In terms of delivering the whole capability to Antarctica, the plan for this season is to deliver the remaining tractors and groomers into Casey by air. On station, once it's delivered, we'll spend the remainder of the summer building the traverse capability. The reason we're doing that, so in the season of 2022-23, we can look to stage our first traverse out of Casey Station.